we're flying a little robot around inside my stomach. It's our intention to go as far into the human body as we can. It needs to work outside of a hospital. It needs to work in sub-Saharan Africa. I'm just waiting for the day where a doctor calls us up and said, we saved a life today. This is the first time we've demonstrated multi-bot flight live. I'm gonna go ahead and swallow this. Wish me luck.
That's insane.
We're in San Francisco to meet Torrey Smith, the co-founder of Endiatx. Their latest invention, PillBot, is a tiny robot designed to be swallowed and piloted remotely inside the human stomach. Today, they're going to show us something that's never been captured on camera before.
When we started the company, we didn't even know how the robots were going to move in the body. We just knew that we were going to do it. So early on, we thought, you know, how do we move? Do we screw our way through? I mean, it's terrifying, like, you can feel this.
How do you screw this in your body?
Right? Really, it was almost like kids at a science fair.
Yeah.
We have this mechanism that causes this foot to come out and go backwards, and it's like a walking foot. Mm-hmm. And we thought maybe it could work. But eventually, one of our doctors said, you know what? If you drink a bunch of water, your stomach will very temporarily fill with water.
Right.
And you might be able to just swim.
Oh.
We took a look at what people were doing with drones. Mm-hmm. And basically, we saw, you know, with quadcopters, right, you get this very elegant three-dimensional motion. And so basically, we said, you know what? Let's make a multi-copter robot. This is PoolBot. Was swimming in the swimming pools of Silicon Valley angel investors in early 2019. But we used this to raise our first round of funding. And then we went through the process of trying to get smaller and smaller. And we started to actually get a lot of traction when we got to this scale.
That's a lot smaller in comparison.
This was when we started to look pretty sophisticated. Mm-hmm. But you can't swallow your thumb. And so from there, we went down to about this size. This is the first pill that we actually swallowed, the first true pill bot. And at this point, we had what we thought were the smallest electrical motors in the world. Mm-hmm. We've since gone a little bit smaller. And this thing was fully functional, but it had terrible video quality.
Okay.
And it sank like a stone. At that time, lithium battery technology was not quite keeping up with what we needed to build a tiny robot pill. But we had faith that if we kept building, the batteries, they would improve on their own, right?
Oh, that's a leap of faith.
So from here, the size was more or less small enough to swallow. This is the largest pill I've been able to find so far. We're beginning to approach that size, but some of the robots that we'll be playing with today still definitely exceed it in length and diameter. But we are already beginning to talk about how we could go below that size. And so it's very important that people understand the human stomach is a great place to begin,
yeah,
but it's nowhere near the end of where we want to go. My personal mission is to go to rice grain size.
Rice grain size.
Absolutely. At rice grain size, we would be able to go everywhere in the human body. And it's a completely new set of hardware and enabling power cells that would make that possible. But it is our hope that we never stop this adventure. With that said, can I show you around how we actually design and build these?
Yes, please. I'm very fascinated.
Awesome. But I'd kind of like to show you what we're really up against. This is the modern endoscope. This is the way that we look inside the human body relatively non-invasively today. The problem is most patients are going to require being sedated, and this is going to be done in a hospital setting. Mm. There's going to be multiple clinical people around, like anesthesiologist, the doctor, all these nurses, and this poor patient may have to go to the hospital 3, 4, 5 times,
right,
before they can actually get the procedure.
Right.
And so what it means is it's super expensive to get a quick look around inside the human body. We scope ourselves frequently, and we notice that, you know, it tears up your throat, it can affect your voice. And it's just, although it's not a surgical cut down,
right,
it is low invasiveness with respect to surgery. it's still a very heavy footprint.
Yeah, I really hope that it will come to realization, because it will save so much pain from so many people.
It should be faster, better, cheaper. But also, it's a platform that you can build other things onto.
Yeah.
But let me show you how we actually build these.
Yes, please.
I'd like to show you PillBot on the computer. You can kind of think of PillBot as a little bit of submarine, a little bit of blimp, if you will. It actually needs to float in the water. If it's heavy, it just sinks. And then we have to run this motor very aggressively, and this poor battery gets drained.
Oh.
And so what we do is we design this system so that pockets of air are actually floating the heaviest parts,
mm-hmm.
not just neutrally in the water, but also with a certain balance. When you get very, very small with a little submarine, the water feels thicker and thicker and thicker. It's almost like we're swimming through honey. Mm-hmm. And so our little propellers are tuned to work in that environment. We've worked really hard to slowly build up the kind of bandwidth we need to get live video through. It has to be live. It has to be crisp, good video. And I would say, honestly, I think we probably need about 4x what we have right now. But let me actually show you where we assemble these.
Yes, please.
We're just trying to get control over all of the processes, because every time you build a robot, if the temperature is very different, then the plastic component might be absorbing more or less moisture. That all affects the mechanical performance.
Right.
And as we've really started to dial the robot in, all of a sudden the margin for error becomes much less, basically get it right. This device is similar to the human body. You need to be able to see, and that's the camera. But also we need to be able to create light. So you have those yellow LEDs mm-hmm. are super powerful. I almost feel like the camera is the eyeball. And then on the second island, it's kind of like the visual cortex. On this second island to the right of the camera is where we do the digital image compression. That camera creates a huge flood of data, far more data than our radio could ever broadcast. And so what we do is we do a very advanced form of image compression on the robot itself. That was one of the magic bullets to make this possible. On the third island is our microprocessor. And so that's basically the brain of the device. And that also features the radio, which we use to communicate through the human body. The very last island mm-hmm. Is the legs of the device.
What are those, like the round knob over here? What are those?
So those are actually basically little balls of solder that will allow us to solder other components on later if we need to. So they're pre-soldered, and you can basically just heat it up and add a component.
That was like a little universe in here.
There's a whole world of improvement that we can do beyond what you see here.
Before we send PillBot into Tori's stomach, Méline gets a chance to try it out. Inside this tank is the same type of robot Torrey will soon be swallowing. It's small, wireless, and controlled entirely through a games console controller. Torrey will be swallowing two robots. The first has no driver and will act as a camera inside his body. The second is the PillBot we see here. The hope today is that the two bots will capture video of each other, live from inside Torrey's stomach.
All right, so let's get clinical here. So we're gonna do a couple of fun things. I'll go ahead and drink a bunch of water.
Okay.
You know, to make this a little bit more fun, I'll try to drink as much as I can to just give ourselves extra stomach volume to swim around it.
Okay.
It's gonna take me a minute or two to drink this or most of this. So here I go. The things I do for science. Okay, that's probably enough for now. So this is the antenna that's actually just one antenna for the simple camera bot. So let's see if we can activate it. And so hopefully we can get a view here. Right now we call it multi-bot, where we can have many robots, many computers. Some of them can work together. It's a more complicated software stack, mm-hmm. But it really opens up if nothing else, just a much more fun demo today. So I'm going to put it in my mouth, and when I swallow, I'm going to try to follow it down with this antenna.
Oh.
I'll try to keep connectivity the whole time.
Oh.
Okay, so we're heading down my esophagus.
Oh.
We're down into my stomach, and boom. Yeah, so we're in the stomach.
Oh.
There you
wow.
go. You can see I'm shaking around.
Yes,
and
we're getting really intimate here. We are seeing his
yeah.
stomach.
Yeah, if I lean over here, you
yes.
can see one side, the other. We have a very high field of view. So you can see kind of a lot of stuff. We're a little bit fuzzy, but that's okay. You know, we're always trying to get you a nice video signal.
Yeah.
Try to move a bit to mm-hmm. get rid of this bubble.
So one thing I can do it a little.
Oh, the bubble is gone.
A little swish.
Oh.
So I swish around, and that sort of clears things up. The bubbles go to the top. You can see bits of mucus are gonna, they'll sort of get pulled off the walls and they'll float up to the top. The idea is hopefully we create a nice fish tank to swim in, right?
Yeah.
Now that we've got a cameraman live in my stomach, let's go ahead and see if we can activate Pillbot to actually go swim around. Pillbot is gonna be a very similar robot to what you were just driving in the fish tank.
Yeah.
The difference is though, in the fish tank, we can close it with tape, but when we're going to swallow it, we close the entire robot off permanently.
And how does those bots come out?
Well, you go to the bathroom and you just go ahead and flush.
Okay.
The robot itself is very inexpensive. Mm. The physical components that went into it, the motors that buzz a cell phone
mm-hmm.
Make up the motors we use. We want it so inexpensive that anyone in the world could have it, maybe several times a year if they need.
Okay, you're going to swallow another pill bot now?
Yeah, so this one is going to be the swimmer.
Oh my God.
Shall we?
Yes.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Try to tilt the robot.
Here is what Pillbot sees, and hopefully we'll get a chance to actually see the robot swim past. There we go.
Oh, you see both bots.
There we go. No, you don't feel this. And it didn't even catch me on the way down. What this means is we're flying a little robot around inside my stomach, but we're not in a hospital.
Yes.
I'm not sedated.
Yes.
Right? I could be in my living room and we could have the best gastroenterologist in the world driving it. And what we're really just trying to do is basically create the world's first virtual endoscope so that for the world of endoscopy, maybe endoscopy can come from the hospital to wherever you are.
I just still can't get my mind around. I'm looking at you and I'm looking inside your stomach with those two bots, you're just holding it. That's insane.
This is actually the first time we've demonstrated multi-bot flight live
yeah.
before anyone.
Thank you.
And it's just incredible because there's a huge market, but really we're just kind of hoping that people get inspired to go further with us. If we can do this today, I mean, what can we do tomorrow? Beyond that, I think we have to put surgical tools on it. If you find a stomach polyp like we have in our clinical trials, cut the thing off, cauterize it. It's our intention to go as far into the human body as we can, right? My personal ambitions involve going into the brain. I'm just waiting for the day where a doctor calls us up and said, we saved a life today.
Yeah.
But, you know, until then, I have to hold my hand up and say, this is still in the clinical process. It's not yet FDA cleared. You know, we're hoping to actually hit the market in a year or two. But in the meantime, it's just an incredible honor to be able to share the adventure with you.
So is it safe to swallow a little robot?
Well, tell you what, once we've been through the proper FDA process, we will be able to tell you how we ultimately scored on safety, efficacy, and whether or not the physicians actually want to use it. That's really the trinity that you get out of an FDA trial. Right now, I can tell you that I've swallowed 86 robots,
yeah.
And so far I feel good. But that does not yet give me the authority to tell you that it's safe.
Okay.
I sure hope that what we're building is safe today and safe for millions of people.
Okay. And what are the data it's collecting?
It's a flood of video data, but if you think about it, there are many other things we could learn. Temperature, acidity, we could be collecting microbiome samples.
Oh.
We could be delivering microbiome transplants,
ooh,
right? It could be listening to the heart, right?
And where you see PillBot heading towards in 5 years?
Well, we just got a very important patent granted for PillSurgeon. PillSurgeon puts the clippers, the snippers, the injection, the tissue sampling, the lab on chip. That all falls into PillSurgeon territory. I want to go as far as we can go. I feel like we need to go to the rice grain level. So as small as we make it, it needs to power itself.
Yeah.
It needs to work outside of a hospital.
Mm.
It needs to work in Sub-Saharan Africa for a simple villager to just get a tiny little package, swallow it, or maybe even let it crawl into, you know, a tiny needle poke,
right?
And go anywhere in the human body. I just feel like we need to take the ambition and the energy and the creativity that we see with companies like SpaceX.
Yes.
Right? It's incredible what they're doing. It's so inspirational. Let's take that inspiration and apply it to health technology,
yeah,
right? Let's be just as ambitious with health tech as we are with space and aerospace, all that good stuff.
I'm so grateful for today's tour and to see someone like yourself, your team.
It's an honor to show you PillBot.
Yeah.
We're very happy to be able to really show you what we're working on.
Really, all the best wish for you guys. Thank you for watching this new episode of the HumanWare Project. To help us keep bringing amazing content out and amazing guests, please like and subscribe. Your support means the world to us. Let's go on this journey together as a piece of HumanWare.